But you know, if you're wrong about this, you being
I'm,
hot.
I'm not gonna be wrong.
No, I'm saying if you are wrong, you being hot water. You know that, right?
I'm not gonna be hot water. I'm not wrong.
Because
you're wrong.
No, I'm just saying that if you are wrong. I mean, I agree with what you're saying right there, but if you're wrong,
so.
Then that would mean that you're
gonna help you out right
that
now.
We're lost, man. You know what I'm saying?
Who's the we? What do you mean we're lost?
Everybody, you know, everybody.
Well, we
the white people are lost, yes. They gone. They forget. Their time is up. We're gonna read about them now.
Right. Matthew chapter 11, verse 11. Verily I say unto you,
this is Christ speaking.
Among them that are born of women, there have not risen a greater than John the Baptist.
So this is Christ speaking about John the Baptist. He said, among all people that were born of women, there was none greater than John the Baptist.
Right.
Because John the Baptist paved the way for Christ. It was a forerunner of Christ. Come on.
Notwithstanding.
But Christ said, don't hold on to that.
He that is least in the kingdom of heaven.
He that is least in the kingdom of heaven. The lowest man in the kingdom of heaven. Meaning on this planet Earth when we rule. So you can understand.
Is greater than he.
It's going to be greater than John the Baptist.
And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffering violence.
Wait a minute. The kingdom of heaven suffering violence? What is he talking about? Who's the kingdom of heaven that the Bible is referring to? The nation of Israel. Read it again.
And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffereth violence.
Read.
And the violent take it by force.
And the violent people took the kingdom from Israel by force. Destruction. 70 AD when they destroyed the children of Israel. That's what that's talking about.
I didn't understand. Now that you're saying it like that, now I understand. Yeah, you put it in that way.
Matthew chapter 11 and verse 12. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence.
Suffered violence.
And the violent
people, the Romans, the white man,
take it by force.
Took the kingdom from Israel by force, by destruction. Now give me Acts. Give me Acts 1 and 6.
Book of Acts chapter 1 verse 6. When they therefore would come together.
So when the disciples came together. Listen.
They asked of him.
When they asked of Christ.
Saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel?
Will you give us our kingdom of heaven back?
And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons.
Why? Because Israel had to go into complete destruction. They had to come all the way down and be renamed. These stupid names we have on us. That the whole nation of Israel had to be destroyed to make us learn our lesson for breaking God's laws. He said, but when you had enough of getting your asses whipped and you repent, then I'm going to bring you into your kingdom. I have to speak that way so you can get the complete understanding. Read it again.
And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power.
Because that was going to happen in the future, which is coming up now. That's the reason why you see what you see here. This is all the plans of the Most High. Now give me Revelation. Now we're going to read about what they were talking about. Now we're going to read about what the disciples were crying about.
Right. Revelation chapter 12, verse 3. And there appeared another wonder in heaven.
Start with the second verse. Start with the first verse.
Verse 1.
12 and 1. Listen.
And there appeared a great wonder in heaven.
And there appeared a great wonder in our heaven that we just read.
A woman clothed with the sun.
That's the Israelites. Read.
And the moon under her feet.
Meaning wisdom and understanding.
And upon her head, a crown of 12 stars.
And upon this woman's head, a crown of 12 stars. What is that talking about? The nation of Israel. The 12 stars meaning the 12 tribes of Israel. Listen.
And she being with child
cried. And she, the nation of Israel, being with child cried. What is this talking about? When Herod, that demon, came to kill Christ, looking to kill Christ. That's the history that's coming out of Revelation. A lot of people read Revelation, don't understand that Revelation is a big parable about the rest of the Bible.
Right.
Read.
And she being with child cried.
And she being with child cried.
Travailing in birth and pain to be delivered.
And pain to be delivered. Why? Because the Romans was looking to kill Christ. They were going through families trying to find him. Killing our men. That's what this is talking about. Read.
And there appeared another wonder in heaven. And behold, a great red dragon.
And it said a great red dragon. Why is it saying red dragon there? Because the white man is red. That's his color.
That's
the
right.
Dragon that the Bible is talking about. He's the devil, so you can understand. That's what God said. I know our people are too gummed up in their brain. They can't understand that. That's why they're going to be wasted. Two-thirds of them got to die because their brains is too gummed up. We understand that. We're not falling out and bugging out about that. We understand that. Read.
Having seven heads.
And this red dragon having seven heads. What is the seven head? The seven main reign rulers of the so-called white man. Starting with the Greeks, then the Romans, then the Spanish, the French, the Germans, the Russians, and the British. Those are the seven heads.
And 10 horns.
And 10 horns, the 10 common markets, what they call EEU and NATO.
And 7 crowns upon his head.
The 7 crowns letting you know there were 7 different rulers among this beast. What was the rulers? I just named them for you.
And his tail drew the 3rd part of the stars of heaven.
So the tail, meaning the Romans, drew the 3rd part of the stars of heaven. What is it talking about? He dragged 3 of the tribes into slavery. What was the 3 that he took into slavery? Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, because these were the only tribes that was in Jerusalem during the time when Jerusalem was destroyed. Because the rest of the tribes were already over here calling themselves Indians. That's right, the so-called North American Indians, the Panamanians, the people through North, Central, and South America, the people that you call Indians, are the Israelites. They got that recorded in the history books. Read.
And did cast them to the earth.
Put them in place.
And the dragon stood before the woman.
And the dragon stood before the woman.
Which was ready to be delivered.
Which was ready to be delivered. We're going to find out who this dragon is. Crystal clear.
For to devour her child as soon as it was born.
Who was standing before the Israelites to devour Christ? Let's get it in the history. Like I said, the Bible, the revelation is a parable to the rest of the scripture. Let's read the history of what this is talking about. Matthew 2:13. Let's read.
The book of Matthew 2:13. And when they were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, arise and take the young child and his mother and flee into Egypt.
And flee into Egypt, meaning among dark people where you can hide. You can't hide no white baby in black Egypt. Read.
And be thou there until I bring thee word.
So his whole family was black. Jesus, Joseph, and his mother Mary. Hiding in Egypt, a black land. Read it again.
And when they were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, arise and take the young child and his mother, and take the young child and his mother, and flee into Egypt.
Flee into Africa. Come on.
And be thou there until I bring thee word.
So let me just back up a second. When Christ gave this, when Christ spoke to the Israelites before Jerusalem was destroyed, and the brother was reading it earlier, he said, when you see Jerusalem come past with armies, then know that the destruction of Jerusalem is coming near. So those of you that are here, flee to the mountains. These were the mountains that he was telling them to run to. The same place where Christ was taken for refuge. So what happened when we got into Egypt? 1600 years later, as we migrated to the West Coast, all the way down, we were rounded up by the Africans and the Arabs and sold over here as slaves on the slave ships.
So the Africans,
that's your history, black man.
The Africans knew you were an African.
You damn right they knew it. How in the hell did you think? When they were selling people, who were they selling? They weren't selling their own, they were selling us.
Right.
It tells you that in the book of Joel. Read.
For Herod will seek the young child to destroy him.
For who?
Herod will seek the young child to destroy him.
Herod was a white man, so you can understand. But the Bible says he was the red dragon that stood before the Israelites to kill Christ. That's the history. Now let's go back to the parable.
Revelation chapter 12 and verse 4. And his tail drew the third part of the stars of heaven and did cast them to the earth.
So Romans came in and they destroyed three of the tribes. Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. Those are the ones that did not leave, so you can understand. The three tribes that did not leave were destroyed when the Romans came to destroy it. The rest of us that fled into Africa were the ones that ended up on the west coast to be sold over here later.
Is that according to the book of Isaiah?
That's according to the Most High's word. That's all over the Bible. Just hold on, brother. You know what? Part of it is in Obadiah. Come on.
And the dragon stood before the woman, which was ready to be delivered.
And the dragon stood before the woman, meaning the Israelites, with the 12 stars, the 12 tribes of Israel, and took three of the tribes into slavery. Meaning they destroyed the children of Israel when they came into Jerusalem.
I thought that was talking about Satan casting out.
That didn't even happen yet. We're going to read about that. That did not even happen. We're about to read about Satan being cast out.
Right.
Which is the white man.
Right.
That's what we go. That's why we went to this chapter. We're going to read about it. And it's going to get crystal clear. Read. Give me verse 9.
Verse 9. And the great dragon, which was cast out, that old serpent, called the devil and Satan.
And Satan. That great, the same dragon that stood before the woman, meaning Herod and all his people. That great red, because it's not white. Stop lying when you open your eyes up and you're looking at, talking about some white people. You ain't seen a white man on this earth yet. Stop lying. Your eyes are trying to tell you what color he is, but somehow the brain is not aligned with the eyesight. Read verse 9.
And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil.
Now this is what I was getting to about the disciples. This is what the disciples wanted to hear about. So that great dragon was cast out of his rulership. He's still in his rulership now. When thy kingdom come, that will be done on earth. That's when this is going to come to pass. Read.
That old serpent called the devil.
It is an old serpent. All you so-called white people are the children of the devil, so you can understand. Read.
Called the devil and Satan.
That's what God said. So we're not wrong. Read.
Which deceiveth the whole world.
Now let's find out who this devil is that deceiveth the whole world.
Right.
Where the hell did this come from? Is this in the Bible as Jesus? How is it that the whole planet Earth thinks this is Jesus? Because the devil deceived them. That's what, read it again. Tell them where you're reading it.
The book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 9. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil.
That old serpent called the devil, the great red dragon, so you can understand. Come on.
And Satan.
He's also called Satan. What does the word devil mean? The word devil means evil, 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 and deceiver. Read it again.
And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil.
Come on.
And Satan.
And it's also called Satan. What does the word Satan mean? Adversary, opposer. He's against God. God says God has the Bible, has Christ in the Bible as black. The opposer said no. We're going to make him white, and we're going to say that we're going to make everybody believe that he's this.
So he's not talking about a spiritual being there? An
not
angel?
At all, because he wouldn't use the color red. Don't try to get off the scripture. The Most High is talking about that's white man
that's
being
what I
the devil.
That's
right.
What I
well, your understanding is wrong, buddy. You're wrong now. Read it again.
And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil.
Maybe he needs some help. Let's read the third verse again.
And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon.
It ain't talking about no red spirit. It's talking about a red dragon having 7 heads and 10 horns. That wasn't no spiritual rulership. Those were 7 real rulerships.
Right.
Come on. Verse 4.
Verse 4. And his tail drew the third part of the stars of heaven.
And the tail drew the third part of the stars of heaven. That was the Romans taking 3 of the tribes into slavery. That's in history. that's in the history books. Read.
And did cast them to the earth.
And cast them in captivity. So when it said cast them to the earth, meaning took them out of rulership, so you can understand. Remember that point, that he took them out of rulership and cast them to the earth.
So Satan is not a demonic spirit or...
There is a spiritual force, Satan. But the people of Satan is the so-called white man.
From what you've explained.
From what the Bible is saying.
From what
you don't agree that the Bible is
the same? I agree with the Bible 100%.
Okay, so let's deal with that then.
I just don't think I can wrap my head around it.
Of course you can't wrap your head around it. We ain't expecting you to wrap your head around it. We're expecting the Most High to wrap the sword around the people's heads that don't want to listen to the scriptures. Read.
And behold, a great red dragon, having 7 heads and 10 horns. And 7 crowns upon his head.
That was real rulership. When you read the 17th chapter, it breaks it down clearly.
Okay.
You don't know about that. Don't say it until you know. You sound confused as hell.
No, I understand. I understand what you're saying.
Verse 9. And the great dragon was cast out.
And the great dragon was cast out. Listen.
That old serpent called the devil.
And another part of the scriptures, he's called Lucifer. We'll read about that next, and then we'll close it up.
Come on.
And Satan.
And he's also called Satan, the adversary, the opposer of God.
Which deceiveth the whole world.
That's the biggest clue of all. What man deceived everybody on the planet and got people saying this is Jesus? I see the little kids walking by, talking about, they got Jesus.
Right.
Little kids. 5 years old talking about this is Jesus. You telling me that just happened out of osmosis? The white man, the great deceiver, deceived them.
Right.
But this is not in no part, no, Jesus has, this right here is not in the Bible as Jesus at all. Jesus was a black man that looked like you.
When it said the letter J didn't come into existence until the 1600s. Letter J.
What I have to do with what we're reading?
Well, I'm saying to you, brother. I'm asking you. I'm saying that.
Let me state the point.
Okay.
Let me state the point.
I'm not sure. I said the letter J was in existence up until the 1600s. So before that, there was no such thing as the letter J. It never exists. So it's the Most High's name. Okay. Is that
your brother?
Yeah, listen.
Our people want to.
Yeah,
the problem is.
Sorry.
Our people always want to sound intelligent.
Okay,
the
letter J that
come up into existence in the 1600s.
Before, okay. No letter
J. So you ain't telling me nothing, bro.
We so the name Jehovah doesn't exist, right?
Read. Where we at? Read 9 and 10.
You know what I'm saying?
Revelation chapter 12, verse 9. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil.
Well, hold on a second. Let me deal with this man for just a second. You, the brother with the J. My brother, my man.
Okay.
So before the J came up, according to the Bible?
Iusis. That's what I heard.
What was the word before the Greek language?
I said in the Greek language.
What does the word even mean, brother?
Hey,
the word Hebrew. What does the word even mean?
I don't know.
It means Hebrew. The word even means Hebrew. That's the language that everybody is speaking in the beginning. You understand? So if you want to talk about original languages, your name was Yahawadah. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
So don't interrupt me.
Yeah, he's right.
Revelation chapter 12, and the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil.
The great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil.
And Satan. Which deceived the whole world
with Christianity and lies.
He was cast out into the earth.
He was cast out into the earth. The same way that he took us from our rulership and cast us to the earth, that's where he's going. Where did Israel go? Into slavery. That's where the white man's going. He's going into slavery. Listen.
And his angels were cast out with him.
And all his church music, all that garbage that he's got with people brainwashed with, all that mess is going to disappear when he go down. Listen.
Verse 10. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven.
So when this man go down, listen to what's going to happen.
Now is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God.
That's hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's what we're going to say.
That's true.
The word, the letter J ain't in that either.
How about that, brother? But you
read
know
it again.
Hold on. Question.
And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven.
3:13.
Now is come salvation.
Now is come salvation. Who's that was asking about what are we going to be saved from? It's telling you right here. Read 9 and 10 again.
And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil.
So the white man is going to be cast out of his rulership because he's not supposed to be ruling at all.
Right.
The Israelites are supposed to be ruling. The only reason why we're catching hell is because we broke the laws of God. God punished us so that we can learn our lesson, then he's going to give us our kingdom back when we acknowledge our offense and repent. Read.
And Satan, which deceiveth the whole world.
Come on.
He was cast down into the earth. And his angels were cast out with him.
So when he goes out, he ain't gonna rule a piss pot. He ain't gonna rule nothing.
So angels meaning his messengers?
Everything that's connected with him.
And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now has come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ.
So when the kingdom of heaven comes, that means the white man gonna be in chains. That's what it's right. telling you. That's what that's telling us. Easy to understand. When he is no longer ruling, the Israelites are going to be in power.
Even those that believe in Jesus?
Now give me Revelation 13, 9 and 10.
Revelation!
They don't believe in Jesus. The Most High said that. Ain't no such thing as they believe in Jesus. They're the children of Esau. For they found no place of repentance, though they sought it carefully with tears.
Right.
So you can forget about it.
Revelation chapter 13, verse 9. If any man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
They're going into slavery. Ain't a damn prayer you can say to Satan.
Read. That's right.
He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword.
That's justice.
That's right.
That's justice.
That's right. Here is the patience and the faith of the saints.
This is the patience and the faith of the saints. That's what we the saints are waiting for. That's why it says patience. Because we can't wait to put a chain on their hands for what they did to us. Now give me Isaiah 14. You said it's a spiritual thing? Start with the 11th verse. Isaiah chapter 14. Yeah.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 11.
Start with verse 1.
Verse 1.
Go from 1 to 3, then jump over here. So it's going to stay in the same chapter.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1.
Listen.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob. No other nation is going to get this mercy. Because Jacob was the vessel of God's mercy. When you read the book of Romans in the New Testament, he said that he has the children of Jacob as the vessel of mercy, and he got the children of Esau for the vessel of wrath. He made Esau the child. So you can understand. That's this whole purpose. The reason why he was put on this earth is for God to exercise his power of destruction through. That's why he got the weapons. Because God is going to destroy him with those weapons. And he's going to show the whole planet earth that he had the power all the time. Read.
And will yet choose Israel.
And will yet choose Israel. Meaning after all the whole thing is over with, he is still choosing the Israelites.
And set them in their own land.
He's going to take you back to your homeland because you don't know where your homeland is. Your homeland is Jerusalem. You're the Israelites of the promised people. You are exiled from your land
from
protect the
God's laws.
And you were brought away into a captivity to serve punishment.
And the stranger shall be joined with them.
So wait a minute, the other nations are going to be there? Well, let's see how they're going to be.
And they shall flee to the house of Jacob. And the people shall take them and bring them to their place. And the house of Israel shall possess them.
And the house of Israel shall possess the nations. The stranger shall be understood. The word is flawless. We shall possess the heathen. Come on.
And the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids.
They're going to be a slave, just like the New Testament said. They're going to be servants and handmaids. The scripture said that they're going to be forced to build a wall.
That's right.
Is that in any nation that said they will not build, they shall be utterly wasted. They're going to be forced to build bridges and roads, all of that, just like you blacks did over here. Let's reap what you sow.
That's right.
Our people got such an inferiority complex in their mind, they can't believe that God would actually speak favorable about them. And you're the jewels that God is talking about in the Bible.
That's right.
Read.
And they shall take them captives.
And we shall take them captives.
Whose captives they were.
Whose captives we were. We're going to take them into captivity. Like they took us into captivity, we dragging their asses in chains. I got to speak plain so you can get it. Read.
And they shall rule over their oppressors.
If you didn't understand all of that, you understand that part. We shall rule over our oppressors. That's plain. Come on.
And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall give thee rest from thy sorrow.
And it shall come to pass that the Lord shall give you rest from your sorrow, because you're catching hell. You're catching hell. You're crying about justice. You're crying about Trayvon Martin. You're crying on your jobs. You're crying about all kinds of hell and destruction that's happening. Your sons are locked up in prison. Your daughters are pregnant. Your little boys are on drugs. Can't get a job. All of that's hell and sorrow. The Lord said, I'm going to take you away from that. The only thing you need to do is repent. And I will destroy your enemies and set you on high.
How do you repent?
Read.
And from thy fear and from the hard bondage wherein thou was made to serve.
Read that part again. And from thy fear.
And from thy fear.
So he said,
read the verses. Read that statement before that.
And it shall come to pass in the day that the Lord shall give thee rest from thy sorrow.
And the Lord shall give us rest from our sorrow.
And from thy fear.
And from our fear. We wake up in fear. We're afraid.
And from the hard bondage wherein thou was made to serve.
That's the key. And he's going to take us from the hard bondage wherein we were made to serve. Where were we made to serve hard bondage at? Right here in Babylon the Great. That's what this chapter's talking about. This chapter's talking about the destruction of Babylon the Great. Give me verse 12.
How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer?
So when Babylon goes down, that's when there's Lucifer going down with it. Read the whole thing. 12, read it.
How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer?
That did not happen yet. That's going to happen when the Lord's prayer come to pass.
Son of the morning!
And he told everybody that he was the bright star of wisdom. He got everybody thinking that if you want to know anything, come to me, wait. And that's how our people think. Our people allow the white man to decide what's right and wrong for them. Decide what's good and evil. That's what he meant when he says a bright star. He tells everybody he's a star of justice. He's a damn thief. He's standing on stolen land and he's talking about justice. Got churches set up on stolen property. And our people are so bugged out they can't even see that. That's the great deceiver. Read.
How art thou cut down to the ground?
How art thou cut down to the ground?
Which this weakened the nations.
How did Satan weaken the nations? How did Lucifer weaken the nations? By dropping bombs on them. By taking their resources. By sending his military over there. Putting military bases in other people's land. Telling them where they can and cannot fly their own planes.
Right.
Read.
For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven.
That's what he did. What he said, I will ascend into heaven. The white man is going into outer space.
That's what he did in the Dominican.
I will exalt my throne above the stars of God.
That's letting you know clearly that he wasn't up there in the heavens with the Most High. Because it said he will ascend his throne above the stars of God. What's that talking about? Space station.
I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation.
I will also sit upon the mount of the congregation. What is the mount of God's congregation? The Israelites. How is he sitting on us? He got us in slavery. He got us in captivity. You're modern day slaves right now. You think you're free. You're modern day slaves. You got your nose one level above the waterline trying to survive.
In the sides of the north.
In the North America. That's where we at. Keep reading. This is Babylon the Great.
I will ascend above the heights of the clouds.
But it's airplanes. Who else is out there? Is the Negro out there?
No.
Come on.
I will be like the Most High.
I will be like the Most High. Let's get the criminal again.
Right.
I will be like the Most High. Come on.
Yet thou shalt be brought down to hell.
Yet, although you did all of this, I'm still bringing you into captivity.
Right.
Read.
To the sides of the pit.
I'm bringing you down into destruction. the Lord is going to destroy this man for your benefit, to bring you into what? Your kingdom. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth. So he's got to get rid of this present ruler.
They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee.
They that see Satan, they that see Lucifer, wait a minute. They that see him,
right?
How they gonna see him? Because he's a man. The scripture gonna tell you that.
That's
and it's
right.
Not talking about one, all the so-called white people are the children of the devil.
That's right.
All of them. Even the little unborn babies.
That's right.
God made it that way. Read.
They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee.
They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee. What does that mean? That means when the Israelites wake up from their dead stupor, they're going to realize that this man is a piece of garbage. They're going to take a good look at him. They're going to be like, this piece of crap ruled over us. That's what that means.
I got mixture in my family.
Read. That's too bad, brother.
And consider thee.
If that's the case, if your father is a white man, we'll see you enslaved.
No, my dad's not a white man, no.
All right. Like, well, if he is, we'll see you enslaved. Read.
And consider thee, saying.
Read that verse again.
They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee.
So they that get the understanding of what the Most High is talking about shall narrowly take a good look at the white man.
And consider thee, saying.
And consider him, saying.
Is this the man?
Is this the what?
The man.
Is this the what?
The man.
Is this the man? So that's the Lucifer that fell out of heaven.
That's right.
So what heaven is it talking about? His rulership. That's what the disciples was crying about in the Lucifer.
Right.
You got that? You understand
that? It's altered state. It's altered state.
It's meaning his rulership. Let's keep it simple. That's so that way everybody can understand it. In other words, he ain't gonna rule a piss pot. Give me the 21st verse. Same chapter.
Prepare slaughter for his children.
God said prepare slaughter for his children.
For the iniquity of their fathers.
For the crimes that their fathers have committed on this earth. God said for us to prepare slaughter for him.
That's right.
That's reap what you sow. Read it again.
Prepare slaughter for his children.
That's a commandment that the Lord told the Israelites, the saints. Prepare slaughter for his children.
For the iniquity of their fathers.
For the crimes that their fathers have committed on this earth by destroying the Native American Indians, by destroying the so-called Negroes, by destroying the Puerto Ricans, by destroying the Haitians, by destroying the so-called Dominicans, by destroying the Panamanians. The Lord said, prepare slaughter for his children.
For the iniquity of their fathers.
For the crimes that their fathers committed, he's going to make the children pay for them. That's going deep because they are their children.
Right.
They are their fathers.
That's
just
right.
Just like we are our fathers in the past. The Lord only has four generations of people that keeps coming back in this earth. So when we catch hell, when it said reap what you sow, it literally meant that we were the same spirits that was back there with Moses, giving Moses a hard time. We was giving Christ everybody a hard time. So the Lord said, you are going into captivity.
Reincarnation?
Just be quiet. Did those people that was with Moses, give me that Deuteronomy 28. Let me just touch it for a second. I don't want to get too deep. Y'all need to come to class. You need to go online and learn. Deuteronomy 28.
Chapter 28.
Yeah, read that.
Verse 68.
Yeah, give me something clear. Something
that's
32. Yeah, give me 32.
Verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Moses was telling this to the Israelites that was in the wilderness. He says, your sons and your daughters shall be given to another people. The people that were listening to Moses, did their children get sold to another people? I'm asking you.
Yes.
Listen to my question. The direct people that Moses spoke to, he says, thy sons and thy daughters shall be given to another people. My question is, did those people that Moses was speaking to, were they themselves, did their children go into slavery? No. So what does this mean? That means later on in generations down, those same spirits were going to come back and they were going to go into captivity. That's the reason why we're over here calling ourselves Negroes. Because we lost who we were. That's what the Bible's talking about. A lot of people come up here act like the Bible's a fairy tale. Dumb as hell. They don't know the Bible. Where we at? Yeah, Isaiah 14. Read that. Verse 21. Read it there.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 21. Prepare slaughter for his children, for the iniquity of their fathers.
For the crimes that their fathers have committed they're going to pay for it. The ones that's walking around right now. If the kingdom come today, those are the ones that was whipping us into slavery. Those are the ones that was hanging and lynching us in the past. Those are the ones that burnt our people at the stake. Those are the ones that were murdering our forefathers when we got off the ships.
Right.
That's what the Lord mean when he said, reap what you sow. Everybody going to pay for what they did. Ain't nobody escaped.
That's right.
That's what you call justice. Not this garbage that you expect in a courtroom downtown, no. The real justice is in the Bible. And they got a nerve to have a Bible in the courtroom and they bringing out justice. Now, give me Psalms 149. Psalms 149.
The book of Psalms, chapter 149. Verse 2. Let Israel rejoice in him that made him. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king.
Let the children of Israel, Zion be the monument of the nation, men of Israel. Let the children of Israel be joyful in their king.
Let them praise his name in the day.
Let them praise his name in the day. This is the name of him.
Verse 5, let the saints be joyful in glory.
Let the saints be joyful in glory. What is glory? The kingdom of heaven.
Let them sing aloud upon their beds.
And when we're going to be on our beds ruling the whole planet Earth. That's what the kingdom of heaven is about.
Let the high praises of God be in their mouth.
The high praises of God is going to be in our mouth. What is that? It's the laws. We're going to enforce the laws. Everybody on this earth is going to have to bow down to the laws of God. That's what he meant when he says that every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. They're going to obey every law in this Bible or they're going to get instant death. Instant. Read.
Let the high praises of God be in their mouth and a two-edged sword in their hand.
And a two-edged sword going to be in our hands.
To execute vengeance.
To do what? To execute what?
Vengeance.
To execute vengeance.
Upon the heathen.
Upon the heathen, meaning the nations.
That's right. And punishments upon the people.
They're going into slavery. Ain't afraid of the state to stop it.
To bind their kings with chains.
We've been reading that all through the Bible that they're going into slavery for what they did. They bind their kings with chains. So if their kings are going into chains, guess where the regular people go? They're going into captivity.
And their nobles with fetters of iron.
And their noblemen, their top men, they have fetters of iron collars on them.
To execute upon them the judgment written.
To execute upon the nations. The judgment written. What is the judgment written? The whole Bible. That's what we've been reading. We're going to execute upon the nation the Bible.
Necessary for them to survive.